Welcome back to Ask Allison. Here is today's question. How can I start the new year outright when I'm burned out and broke? So first, I want to thank Therapy Notes for sponsoring Ask Allison. If you're looking for an all-in-one practice management system, you need to check out Therapy Notes. It's top rated on Trustpilot. It does all the back-end pieces that our private practices require. You can schedule, charge, bill insurance, do your notes, send reminders, store your intake paperwork, complete online video assessment or sessions all in one place. You get 2 months to play with it for free if you use the code ABUNDANT at checkout at therapynotes.com. All right. First, I want you to take the pressure off. Even like just reading this question, it makes me feel like someone's climbing a mountain. It sounds painful and awful. So you don't have to start the year off right, whatever that means. You can start the year burned out and broke and end the year in a totally different space. You sound like someone who has a long list of shoulds and self-blame, and those aren't helping you. You're struggling, but you're wonderful. I'm not going to therapize you because it's not my role here, but I'm going to point that out because I can't not. So my business consultant part has the following directives for you. And this is going to be in the free worksheet so you can print it out and write it out. Get quiet, get a pen. We're going to address burnout, being broke, and planning for 2022. Let's start with burnout. I personally found that what I do outside of work impacts my level of burnout much more than anything that happens inside of work. I'm also really clear that my perception of the utility of my work and some existential, like what's the point stuff can sneak in. So I wanna start with why you're a therapist. We've talked about this before, but I want you to write out the thing in your life that led you to want to help people in this way. You could have been a doctor or a civil rights attorney or a gardener. Why did you choose to be a therapist? And don't do this halfway. Get into the story of it. Get another sheet of paper if you need to. I'm telling you, I've wanted to quit this work at least a dozen times, maybe two dozen in the past few years. And it's always my why that brings me back. It doesn't invigorate me every single time, but it does bring me back to the things that can get me reinvested. What is your extracurricular life like? If you're coming home or out of your home office at the end of the day and you're making a quick dinner and then you're vegging out in front of the TV or scrolling your phone, you're going to be burned out no matter what your job is. Your life is boring. It's your job to make it not boring. I got into this space in 2020 when I felt like everything was an obligation. I bemoaned all the obligatory Zoom classes my kids had that because of their age, I was responsible for getting them into while trying to work. I bemoaned my work schedule being messed up with the lack of childcare and our one room home office that my partner and I were passing back and forth between us over the course of the days. I bemoaned the therapists who weren't moving online because they thought that this was only going to last 2 weeks. Remember when we tried to like flatten the curve? And I was in full victim of my circumstance mode. And for me, that means I'm responsible for everything. I have to do it all. And here's what I've come to since then. Yes, everything is still an obligation. Everything will always be an obligation forever for all of us who have made bold choices to have a career, to have children, to have a partner, to buy a house, to have a car, to have a pet. I want an interesting life. I could have chosen Netflix all day, every day in my parents' basement. For me, that'd be a path to deep, unending depression. Instead, I chose my obligations based on my values, and I'll choose them again and again. So my question here is, what obligations did you choose and why? I'm not talking about the things we don't have control over. I'm talking about the stuff that you made a decision about. Look at each of these and be really honest with yourself. Are you fulfilling this obligation as if you chose it or as if it was thrust upon you? If you're feeling like a victim of this thing you chose, is that because you need to approach it differently or because you need to let it go? If you need to let it go, what's the plan for that? Start brainstorming that now and come back and flesh it out some every day until it feels solid and real. Now let's talk about being broke. There are two versions of broke. The I don't have money to do the things I want to and I feel broke version and the I don't have the money to pay my bills and am broke version. So get clear on which you are. Neither version is where you want to be, but the latter is considerably more dire and considerably more stressful. So get real with yourself about if your problem is an income problem or an expenditure problem. Most of the time in our profession, it's an income problem. But if you're leasing a Mercedes on $30,000 a year, it may also be expenditure for you. If you aren't bringing in enough money to fund the lifestyle you want, figure out what you want and need, and then increase your fees and see the number of clients that you want to see. If you don't know how to do either of those, then come and work with me so that I can walk you through it. And I'll put a link for how to do that with folks in the caption. If you make good money and it's a spending problem, consider finding a financial therapist. Ask yourself, what's this spending represent? What do those things that you're spending money on do for you? In what ways is the spending or are the things that you're getting making you feel temporarily good enough? And sort through that, because no matter how much money you make, you're going to be in the same place where you're spending it all if you don't figure it out. Now, planning for 2022. Much of the time, we set outcome goals, like we'll see 25 clients per week, but we don't have as much control over those goals as we'd like. So instead, focus on what you can do. Set process goals, like I'll revamp my websites about me, or I'll blog weekly, or I'll network with two people a week. Make sure those process goals are likely to lead to your income goals, but don't let the outcome impact whether or not you do your process goals. Assess whether they're working, sure, but don't get rid of a strategy without giving it adequate time to work. And don't get rid of it without replacing it with another, unless something else you're doing is already working really well. Check in with yourself. Hopefully you can set up your practice schedule in a way that really works for you. Does it still work for you at this stage in your life? I tend to change something important about my schedule about every 6 months. It'd probably be more often, honestly, if I took some time to check in with myself more frequently. Use the new year as a marker to check in and create a plan for transitioning anything that needs transitioning. Also, take some time to get your vacations in your calendar. I mean, like all the way through the year, like get December's time off in there, put breaks in so you don't chug through the whole year. And what about your fee? Did you set it based on your current and future expenses? Are you saving for retirement? Do your kids have college funds? Now's a good time to do the math. And I recommend Tiffany McLean's Fun with Fees calculator at heytiffany.com. Start planning on a fee increase if one is needed. The last 2 years have been hard. What are you going to do in 2022 to alleviate stress or have more fun or be more playful? Take some time to think through and commit to some process-based personal goals. And please remember that incremental change is necessary for lasting change. If you don't exercise very often, but you know it's an antidote for stress for you, don't go from working out once a month to committing to 5 days a week. Try once a week. Really notice how it impacts your emotional health. Describe it in writing. Then set a goal of 1 to 2 times a week. And if you hate running, stop punishing yourself with running and choose something that your body enjoys. Maybe you need more safe social time, but you're a little out of practice. Get some practice. Commit to instigating or agreeing to one social thing every other week, or more or less often, depending on your situation. Make sure you're actually excited about what you have coming up. And if not, pop something in there that at least makes you smile a little. If anhedonia is the problem, get support. 2022 can be a great year. It's going to take some intentionality, some luck, some planning, but it can be really great. And if you want us to help you, absolutely check out the ways we work with people at abundancepracticebuilding.com/work with us. Happy New Year, everybody. I hope it's magical.